Good morning all.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning. Today we will go for the pipeline and scalar technique. Already I have given you the study material for chapter 6, page number 265 of Kaiwan. Those who have not received it, they are requested to collect it from their friends. My voice is audible to all.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So now continue. Open the page number 265. You will find that linear pipeline processor. As it is an online session, so it is not possible to use the chalk and duster or the board. So you need to refer your study material. In 6.1, you will find the pipeline processor. So what is a pipeline processor? A pipeline processor is a cascade of processor state. That means till now we have find that a single processor is used for process a single instruction, that is called the serial processor. And if more than one processor is used for more than one operation, then it is called the parallel processor. And when the parallel operation will be done, the similar kind of operation if you want to perform at the same time, at the time, this is called the parallel processor. Think A plus B and C plus D you want to perform, then need not wait for completion of the A plus B operation. At the same time, as the two different operand are used for the two different operations, so you may be able to perform it A plus B and C plus D simultaneously using two different processors. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Anyone have any doubt? Then raise the question. So A or B, era to alada, C or D alada. Thale A B ke niye ami jodi kono operation korte chai, thale seta korte pari. Abar C or D ke niye jodi kono operation korte chai, eki samoye korte pari. Thale kono parallel korte pari. But serial processor takes the incremental time. That means after completion of A plus B, you will be able to perform C plus D. And in case of parallel processor, what happens? The different type of operation is required. Now, if the operations are conjugate to each other and they are interrelated to each other, at that time, how you will perform the operation? For that purpose, the pipeline processor is required. In case of pipeline, what happens? The first operation is required the full time to execute.
Full time.
But after completion of the first operation, the other operations are in the queue and they are just waiting to complete their last phase. And if you have the n number of operations and there are k number of stages, then to complete the first operation, it will take the k unit of time. If to execute or complete a single stage, it will take the single unit of time. Okay? So,
yes, sir.
So to complete the n number of tasks, your time requirement will be n into t. And because t is required to complete a single task and k number of stages are there, so n into number of stage into time required is the time required to complete the n number of jobs using a single processor in a serial processor. Serial processor. Eta kothay ache? Amra eta dekhi, dekho. Page number kholo. Page number kholo. Page number 268. Page number 268. Khulecho? Khol kholo. Kholo ne? Dekhachi dekho. Just spin kori. Page number 268. Bhalo kore dekhbe. Dekho. 268 e jao. Page number 268. Page number 268. Dekho.
Achen.
Na pao ni. Ami 270.
Yes, sir.
Ha, page number
270.
Na, page number 268. Dekho. Page na, in page number 265, where my mouse pointer is there, you will find that where T is the clock period on this equivalent function of non-pipeline processor,
which
has a flow through delay KT, then the amount of time it takes to execute n tasks, it is NKT. N is the number of tasks, K is the number of stages, and T is the time. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So it is for a serial processor. Now, if it is a parallel pipeline processor, at the time what happened? KT, that means K is the number of stage and T is the time. Execute the first operation, it will take K amount of time. And after that, N minus 1 amount of task will be completed after taking N minus 1 unit of time. Q. अरे पहला काम खत्म होने के बाद हर वक्त एक एक काम का आउटपुट आएगा. पाइपलाइन में क्या होता है, पहले जब तुम्हारा टैंक खाली रहता है तब टैंक भरने के लिए टाइम लगता है, उसके बाद पाइपलाइन में पाइप हमेशा ही आता है. ये सुन लो. सो इट इज ऑल्सो लाइक दैट. सो k प्लस n माइनस 1 इनटू t इज द एक्चुअल टाइम रिक्वायर्ड इन ए पाइपलाइन. सो kt, सो tk, tk इज द टाइम फॉर द, tk इज द टाइम फॉर द पाइपलाइन प्रोसेसर. ये देखो ना, पहले के लिए क्या हो रहा है, एक काम इनटू के नंबर ऑफ स्टेज इनटू टी टाइम, सो केटी. और उसके बाद एन माइनस वन के लिए और टी टाइम. तो इसको अगर तुम जोड़ोगे तो क्या हो गया है, वन प्लस एन माइनस वन एन नंबर ऑफ टास्क हो गया है, लेकिन के प्लस एन माइनस वन इनटू टी टाइम उसके लिए लग रहा है, और एक सीरियल के लिए एन के टी टाइम लग रहा है. सो व्हाट इज द स्पीड अप, सो स्पीड अप इज इक्वल टू time required for a serial processor divided by time required in a pipeline processor, and it will take nk by k plus n minus 1 time. So this is called the speed up. Now if k is very less and n is very high, that means mano ki char stage hai. What are the different four stage, tell me? Instruction fetch, instruction decode, इंस्ट्रक्शन एग्जीक्यूशन एंड राइट बैक. तो के का मतलब हो गया है चार, एन का मतलब 1000. तो ऊपर में क्या हो गया है, 4 × 1000, 4000. नीचे में क्या हुआ, 4 + 999, तो 1003. सो व्हाट विल बी द इक्विवेलेंट वैल्यू, इक्वल के. एन का वैल्यू बहुत ज्यादा है, तो व्हाट विल बी द स्पीड अप फॉर ए के स्टेज पाइपलाइन, इक्वल के. तो जितना स्टेज बढ़ेगा वो पाइपलाइन का एफिशिएंसी उतना क्या होगा, ज्यादा होगा, अच्छा होगा. ओके चलो एक बार बोलते देखो, बोझा गया, बोझा जाएंगे ना.